My name is DK Pandey and I am from the Business Communication about Tech. Today we are going to demonstrate about the jet engine, that how it is going to work. So here, this is the main unit and it's have the first part, they have the turbine, this is called the exhaust line. After that they have the combustor and the intake option. They have the downside, we are using the oil tank from here. This is called the oil tank. And if you can look that, this is the power supply and the coming from the control panel. Next, here I'm going to give the DC power intake, and I'm using this cool spool as a GPU ground power supply unit to excite and start the engine. The other side of the engine, here we are applying the fuel supply from here. The fuel supply is connected with the setup valve going to the booster, and after the booster is moving to the transmitter of the line. Now this is called the regulator, fuel regulator and pump. So if you can look from here, this engine, this is called the intake engine, like this is called the intake option, and this point we are using as a starter from here, and we are giving the DC power supply, and this is called the igniter of the system. So you can move to the control panel. This is a very important control panel. So how I am going to do that? First of all, we need to give the power supply from here to there, and second, we have to turn on the master. The second, next step, like you have to turn on the fire shuttle valve, then we have to go for the booster on, can you zoom? Then we have to inverter on, and after that we have to wait, and we have to watch carefully this one, the engine valve, first we place that, and less than in between the 12%, once we reach that, we will produce the fuel from here. And always you need to monitor that this EGT is exhaust gas turbine temperature. They must not reach beyond of the 850. If reaching that, immediately we need to stop that something we are doing wrong. So this is all about the system. Thank you.